I am so excited. Not just because I get to get on that helicopter right there, but because we're flying 150 miles offshore to Vito, Shell's new oil and gas platform.
I flew this exact same journey 3 years ago.
You can see that in episode one. It's actually pretty good.
That's when my deep water journey began. But back then, I was heading to a drill ship, this ship. It was drilling 8 wells on the seabed, ready for Vito's arrival. But fast forward to today, and
Vito's in position, it's hooked up, it's ready to start delivering. Are we ready to go? We doing this?
Spatial protein is landing in the
firewall. I'm Kari Byron. I've spent much of my life exploring science, engineering, and technology.
I'm fascinated by how things work. So when Shell said, come on out, check out how deep water energy works, I said, sign me up.
I want to find out how we get the energy that fuels our world. Because when you can just flick a switch, turn a dial, or fuel up with ease and hit the open road.
It's easy to overlook the sheer amount of technology and engineering that goes into capturing the energy we use every single day. Especially when it comes from 5 miles deep underground.
So come with me over 4 episodes and 3 years of my life.
Got a gray hair?
I've got an all-access pass. Following Vito from being built to laying giant steel pipes a mile below the sea. And in this final episode, I'm on board Vito. I find out how Vito is redefining deep water energy for Shell here in the Gulf of Mexico.
Someone told me that there is more advanced engineering in deep water oil and gas production than putting a man on the moon. At this point, I kind of believe them. Look at Vito down there. It's just a red and yellow gleaming island on top of a mile of water. All the engineering and brain work and science make it all come together. It's so cool.
Vito's design brings a brand new way of thinking for Shell in deep water. For a start, it's about a third smaller than previous platforms, yet just as capable of providing much needed energy. Right now, the engineers are testing the onboard systems, ramping up production stage by stage until they hit full capacity in a few months' time. And that's why I'm here, to give them a hand, of course. Waiting for me is Kurt Schallenberger. With 35 years of deep water engineering to his name, he's been leading the team from day one, responsible for putting Vito together.
You must be so proud of this project. What makes it special?
Vito is the culmination of knowledge over decades of learning what is the basics we need to operate. It allows us to get this size smaller, more compact, and efficient. All of that reduces our impact on the environment, both its footprint here in the ocean and the emissions that it makes.
Well, now that we're out here, the whole thing is built. Is it working? Are you actually hitting oil?
We're actually in the ramp-up phase, so it's a really exciting period for us.
Will I physically be able to see oil?
I will take you to see the oil.
All right, it's a plan. But first, let's take a look around. The upper decks, or topside, houses the helideck and the living facilities at one end of the platform. The other end is where the action happens. Fluid from the reservoir comes up from the depths through 3 heavy steel flow lines before being filtered and separated into oil and gas and then pumped ashore. The bottom half, the hull, is made up of 4 cylindrical legs that sit on a pontoon 90 feet below the waterline. Mooring lines on each corner anchor Vito in position. But get this, Vito is actually moored 3 miles away from the well heads, where the oil comes out of the ground. And that's because Vito needs to move. Here's Kurt to explain.
The mooring lines go out about 1.5 miles, and that allows us to move with the waves to reduce the forces on this hull. Those 3 flow lines that go to the well head, they also need a certain amount of distance, and I have something, I can use an example.
You're just keeping a pipe in your pocket?
I just keep a pipe in my pocket. Now, if it went straight down 4,000 feet and then hit the seafloor and we start moving, it'll kink like that. So the way to prevent that is to have a nice gentle slope, and that when we move with the waves, it doesn't break.
It's crazy to think that a pipe that large is bending and moving 3 miles out.
It still blows my mind.
And the other thing that blows my mind is how the subsea teams actually connected those flow lines up to Vito, working in water depths of almost a mile. First, an ROV is used to attach a cable to the flow lines laying on the seabed from an installation vessel up on the surface. The riser is then slowly pulled up and edged closer to Vito. With 4,000 feet of steel now dangling from the ship, weighing 300 tons, there's no room for error. So the load is carefully transferred to a winch on the side of Vito and inched underneath the platform. For the final delicate stage, the riser is maneuvered into a basket on the side of the pontoon, which firmly locks the pipe into position. And Vito is finally plugged in, connected to one of the deepest commercial oil and gas deposits in the Gulf of Mexico, 5 miles below the seabed. So that's the subsea bit of Vito taken care of. Now for what happens on the top side.
Vito is an FPU. I didn't know what that meant before I got here either. Floating production unit. Way out here in the ocean, this platform has 7 miles of pipes. And with all the noise and hustle and bustle, it feels like it's alive.
To get an idea of what all these pipes do with the fluid that comes from the well, I'm meeting Elizabeth. She knows how to make a mean salad. Yep, a salad. Stay watching.
What's going on here?
So, down on the seafloor, we have our risers coming up. You can see it right there, that black pipe.
Okay, and then they end up here.
Yes, in these vessels, a process called separation occurs. So, it comes up to the top sides and is all jumbled up, and then we start to separate. You know when you're opening a can of soda and you hear that noise and that's the gas? We have that gas going into compressors, which you can hear from down here.
That's what all that noise is.
Some of the noise, there's that. There's oil and water also separating out inside these vessels. And I actually brought something to help visualize this for you. So let me grab it.
Visual aids.
Oh. You might be familiar with this.
Nice. That makes so much sense. Salad dressing.
Yep.
Okay, so this right here, what do we got?
We got our gas or airspace on the top in the bottle. The bulk of it right here is our oil. That's the good stuff. That's what we send on shore. And then towards the bottom are the heavier products that separates out that came up from the reservoir.
Okay, so when it starts, it's all just shook up.
Yep,
so like
that's
this.
Right.
And then it settles out, so the sediment's on the bottom.
Uh-huh, sediment and water, oil, and then all the gas.
So far, I've seen Vito in action for the very first time.
It feels like it's alive.
I've learned that the platform is actually 3 miles away from the wellheads.
It's crazy to think that a pipe that large is bending.
It still blows my mind.
And discovered that Vito is lean and mean, because although it's relatively compact, it can deliver 100,000 barrels of oil a day. That's 4.2 million gallons.
Vito's more than a floating bottle of salad dressing. It's also a village. There's a floating community here. Those are the accommodations. They house like 60 people. Come on with me, I'll check it out.
The platform is self-sufficient too. The heating and electricity is generated from the gas that comes from the wells, and the water for cooking and drinking is filtered from the sea. Working patterns for the crew are 2 weeks on board and 2 weeks off, so every effort is taken to make Vito a home away from home.
There, we got traditional Texas chili. No beans in Texas chili. They won't let me back into the state if I put beans into it.
The bedrooms on board are, in real estate speak, compact. You know, 4 to a room, that kind of thing.
So this is my room. I get to share, but everybody's at work right now. Bunk beds. I haven't been in a bunk bed since I was in camp. So I'm bottom bunk. Guess they heard I sleepwalk.
Oh, there's a TV. What are we watching?
Oh, wow. Vito with Kari Byron. Excellent. But this is Saturday night. The real stars of the show are gathered in the mess room for bingo.
Are you ready?
Yep.
I-25.
This is Belle, a specialist engineer who jumped at the chance to get out here and help start up Vito.
G-55.
What made you want to come offshore?
I guess I was just kind of dazzled by deep water and, you know, big facility. And when the helicopter kind of flies in and you see the facility get bigger and bigger, it really kind of clicks like, wow, this is something like really cool that we're doing out here. So
B7.
And what kind of engineering did you go to school for?
I was a petroleum engineer.
Oh, no way. So yeah. You've been trained for this.
I guess so.
Oh, 66.
And there's bingo.
And there's bingo.
Bingo!
Shift starts early on the platform, 5:30 a.m. So by the time I get going, Kurt and the team are already out assessing a potential modification.
That's a bad one.
You see that it's an inside, it's a coalescing filter, so you see all the dirt on the element.
It's been discovered that there's an issue changing filters on the vapor recovery unit. That's the thing that captures the gas.
Either we have to break the housing loose from the mounting bracket, or we're going to end up having to take out all this piping down here because it's all hard welded together.
Vito is a blueprint design for Shell, so any in-field learnings like this provides vital feedback for all future deep water projects.
There's millions of pieces in here, and all the stuff we get right, you don't notice. It's that 5 out of every million. Oh man, what were we thinking?
Finding new and better ways to work is what Vito is all about, setting new standards for offshore working. Like this place. It's cool, eh? You could say I'm in the brain of Vito.
So I'm here in the most important room on the platform. This is the control room. From here, they can monitor everything remotely, from flow, production, safety, even oncoming vessels and the weather.
The entire production can be monitored and even remotely controlled from an identical control room onshore in New Orleans. And smart tech is being used in other ways on Vito too. Check this out, augmented reality. It's used to connect specialists in New Orleans with the guys out here on the front line in real time. This is Scott and Brody. They're running up the last of the 4 gas turbine generators that are needed to power Vito's giant pumps that push the oil and gas 150 miles to shore. And of course, this means even complete amateurs, like myself, can be guided through complex tasks by experts back at base.
Whoa! What is that? Is that a jet engine in a cabinet?
Pretty much. That's a 9,000 horsepower turbine engine. This is actually what produces the power on Vito, all 4 of these units. Now get this, each one of them is capable of 6.4 megawatts. To put that in real terms, Vito right here with these 4 turbines can power about 20,000 homes. But we need so much of the power here is for the giant size pumps we have.
Wow.
We're talking 1,500, 2,500, and over 3,000 horsepower motors. We're gonna start this up.
I get to start the jet engine.
You're gonna get to start a jet engine.
All right, let's do it.
All right.
Starting a jet engine is serious business. There's a checklist of protocols that must be actioned in a sequence in the right order.
Hey there, in New Orleans. What do I do to start this up?
Hey, Kari, we're gonna drop a marker showing you some valve alignment we need you to verify.
Okay, I see. I see the little arrow. Okay. Take this over here.
All right, Kari, you'll see that we pointed out that valve. If you could just walk that line and verify the position.
Yes, okay, the shutdown valve. It's open, now what do I do?
We also need to check the pressure on the pressure indicator.
Yes, there's pressure.
Kari, now can you walk around the enclosure, make sure there's nothing leaking?
Visual check, nothing to see here, so I guess we're good.
This is one of the last pieces of the puzzle to get Vito closer to full capacity. Let's hope it starts. I mean, it's not often you get to power up an oil platform.
That's 6.4 megawatts or 9,000 horsepower. Right here at my fingertips. It's gonna be really, really loud.
Yeah, it's good. Yeah.
5. Hear that?
Yep.
That sounds like an airplane starting. We're over 1,000 degrees. Woo! You hear that?
And on that thrilling and successful contribution, there's one last thing that needs my professional attention.
Because now, I finally get to get hands-on with what this is all about.
Hey, I promised to show you oil. Here's your opportunity. I'd like to introduce you to my friend Eddie.
This is Eddie. He checks what's coming out of the ground at least once a day.
So this is being piped up from 5 miles down.
5 miles down and 3 miles away.
So what's coming out here is not processed. It's coming straight from the ground.
Straight from the ground.
Is it hot? Is that steam?
It's pretty hot coming out the ground. Woo. That's not steam. That's actually natural gas that's already separating from the crude. Isn't that incredible?
So there you have it, Vito, Shell's most efficient platform. Extreme engineering and clever science brought together to capture the deep water energy that powers our lives.
Kurt, thank you for the education on this extreme engineering. I had no idea how much goes into something that I take for granted every day.
It's been our pleasure to have you here. It's an exciting time for us. I'd like to point something out, if that's okay.
Sure.
Big pipe on the right is oil. Little pipe on the left is gas. Both of those come under our feet, down the hull column, and off to the distance onshore. Onshore, that oil is turned into fuel for our cars, and that gas is gonna feed the grid for power plants and also to cook our food. If you think of Vito will be here 25 years when I'm in my walker and someone halfway across the country is gonna flip on their hot shower, it's something that I can be proud of and the whole team can be proud of.
I can't picture you with a walker.
Yeah, you don't know, you know? It'll be a souped up walker.
If you want to know more about Vito or the future of deep water oil, check out some of my previous films here, or some of the other great engineering films from Shell here.
Don't miss out on future shows. Subscribe to Shell by clicking the logo.